surface machining, getting started. Before getting to grips with all of the surface machining capacities, here are two short step-by-step tutorials that will help guide you through the key functionalities. You will learn how to use the core functions and learn how to define areas on the part to machine, use specific machining operations on the part and output data. There are two ways of defining your manufacturing program. You can either base it on operation definition or on area definition. Let's start with operation-oriented machining. Operation-oriented machining is a method where you define each operation one by one. When you define an operation, you decide which areas of the part you want to machine with that particular operation, using the Geometry tab. In this tutorial, you can find how to define the operations necessary for the machining of the sample part. Run the program to create the tool paths. Check for residual material. Rework the unmachined areas. And produce an APT file and a workshop document. You can find all necessary files using the link given in the description. Rough machining the part. This task shows you how to insert a rough machining operation in the program. In this operation, you will specify the geometry, the tool path style, and the tool characteristics. Open the Surface Machining 3CAD product. Select Machining and then Surface Machining from the Start menu. The Surface Machining workbench is displayed. The part surrounded by the rough stock is displayed in the Setup Editor window along with the machining specifications. Select product 1 containing the shape to machine, and the rough stock, in the specifications tree and display them in wireframe mode, selecting wireframe from the view toolbar. Double-click part operation 1 in the tree. In the dialog box that is displayed, click the design part icon. Select open body 1 under product 1 and in shape to machine in the tree. Double-click in the viewer to validate your selection, and to redisplay the dialog box. Then click the stock icon. Select part body under product 1 and in rough stock in the tree. Double-click in the viewer to redisplay the dialog box. Click OK to confirm. The design part defines the reference part that will be used by the application to compute the residual material. The rough stock is the rough stock for the overall part. Each successive operation works on the residual material that is left by the operation before it in the manufacturing program. Now select Manufacturing Program 1, under Part Operation 1 in the Specifications tree to make it the current entity. A program must be current before you can insert program entities such as machining operations, tools and auxiliary commands. Click Roughing. A Roughing 1 entity and a default tool are added to the program. The Roughing dialog box is displayed. The status light on the Geometric Components tab is red, which means that you must select the part geometry in order to create the operation. Click the red area that represents the part. The dialog box shrinks to allow you to select the part in the viewer. In the viewer, click the part. Double-click anywhere in the viewer to confirm your selection and to redisplay the dialog box. The red area in the geometric area is now green to indicate that their geometry has been selected. Click the sensitive area that represents the rough stock. The dialog box shrinks to allow you to select the rough stock in the viewer. In the viewer, click the geometry that defines the rough stock. The red area in the Geometric Components tab is now green to indicate that their geometry has been selected. Go to the Machining Strategy tab and select Helical as Tool Path Style. Go to the Tool tab and change the name of the tool to T1 and MIL D20. Then click More. Change nominal diameter to 20 mm. Overall length to 120 mm. And cutting length to 90 mm. Click Tool Path Replay. The tool path is displayed and the Display and Analysis dialog box is called up. Click OK. The tool path is erased from the viewer and you come back to the Operation dialog box. Click OK to close the dialog box. Now we're going to use Z-level machining on the walls of the pocket and the outside of the part. Z-level machining of the outside of a part. This task shows you how to use Z-level machining for finishing the outside of the part. To simplify the selection of faces in this task, select rough stock in the product list and, using the Hide Show option in the contextual menu, make it invisible. Change the view mode to shading with edges using View Toolbar. Make sure that roughing 1 is the current entity so that the Z-level operation will be inserted after it. Click Z-level. Z-level 1 entity is added to the program. The Z-level dialog box is displayed. Right-click the sensitive red area that represents the part and choose Select Faces. The dialog box shrinks and the Face Selection toolbar is displayed. Select all of the walls that form a belt around the part. Click OK. The dialog box is redisplayed and the red area is now green. In the viewer, the edges around the selected faces are highlighted. Click the check element in the sensitive icon to select the upper face of the part. Go to the Machining Strategy tab and select Outer Part for the machining mode. Go to the Macro tab. Select Approach and change it to Along Tool Axis. Use the contextual menu to save the macro definition. In the dialog box that is displayed, create a new catalog in the location of your choice to store your macros. Select Retract. Change it to Along Tool Axis and set the distance to 80 mm. Save using the contextual menu. Select Between Passes and change it to Defined by Linking Approach Retract. Save using the contextual menu. Click Tool Path Replay. The tool path is displayed and the Display and Analysis dialog box is called up. Click OK. The tool path is erased from the viewer and you come back to the Operation dialog box. Click OK to close the dialog box. The operation you have just created should still be the current entity. Now we're going to define the Z-level machining of the pocket. Z-level machining of the inside walls of a part. This task shows you how to use Z-level machining for finishing the inside walls of the pocket. Make sure that Z-level 1 is the current entity so that this operation will be inserted after it. Click Z-level. A Z-level 2 entity is added to the program. The Z-level dialog box is displayed. Right-click the sensitive red area that represents the part and choose Select Faces. The dialog box shrinks and the Face Selection toolbar is displayed. Select all of the faces that form the inside wall of the pocket. Click OK. The dialog box is redisplayed and the red area is now green. In the viewer, the edges around the selected faces are highlighted. Go to the Machining Strategy tab and select Pockets only for the machining mode. Click Toolpath Replay. The toolpath is displayed and the Display and Analysis dialog box is called up. Click OK. The toolpath is erased from the viewer and you come back to the Operation dialog box. Click OK to close the dialog box. Now we're going to define a sweeping operation for the top surface of the part and bottom of the pocket. Sweeping to finish the part. This task shows you how to use sweeping for finishing the part. You are going to define two separate operations, one for the top surface and another for the bottom of the pocket. Make sure that ZLevel 2 is the current entity so that the sweeping operation will be inserted after it. Click Sweeping. A sweeping 1 entity is added to the program. The sweeping dialog box is displayed. Right-click the sensitive red area that represents the part and choose Select Faces. The dialog box shrinks and the face selection toolbar is displayed. Select the top surface of the part. Click OK. The dialog box is redisplayed and the red area is now green. In the viewer, the edges around the top surface are now highlighted. Click Toolpath Replay. The toolpath is displayed and the Display and Analysis dialog box is called up. Click OK. The operation you have just created should still be the current entity. Repeat all of the above steps for the bottom surface of the pocket. As check elements, add the elements that were last machined in sweeping 1. In the macro tab, change the approach to a long tool axis with a value of 60 mm. Click OK after tool path computed. Checking the results. This task shows you how to visually check the machined part resulting from the toolpaths for the operations you defined in your manufacturing program. Your specification tree should look like as shown. Right-click Manufacturing Program 1. Select Manufacturing Program 1 object and pick Replay Toolpath. The Display and Analysis dialog box is displayed. Click Shown icon to go from one operation to the next, displaying the computer tool path after each operation. If any of the operations were not computed with Replay, they will be computed at this stage. You can display a photo of how the finished part would look with the camera icon. Click OK to close the dialog box. Creating a rework area. This task shows you how to define an area to rework from the areas of the part that were not machined with the tool used in the operations. You must compute the tool paths for your manufacturing program first. Click Rework Area. Click the red area that represents the part. The dialog box shrinks to allow you to select the part in the viewer. Select the part. Double-click anywhere in the viewer to confirm your selection and to redisplay the dialog box. Enter a value of 10 mm for the entry diameter and 2 mm for the corner radius. Click Compute. This creates a rework area, which remains the current entity. The areas that we're going to rework are displayed. Click OK to close the dialog box. Reworking. This task shows you how to rework the areas of the part that have not been machined and where there is residual material. You must have created a rework area. A rework area is an area that cannot be machined with a given tool. The rework area must be the current entity. If you have doubts about whether the rework area you just defined is still the current entity or not, click the manufacturing view icon. Then select the rework area from the list. Click ZLevel and click OK to close the dialog box that opens. In the manufacturing view window, double-click the tool that is associated with the third ZLevel operation. Double-click the tool diameter. Enter a value of 5. Click OK to confirm the tool diameter and then OK to close the tool definition dialog box. Still in the manufacturing view window, double-click ZLevel 3 to display the ZLevel dialog box. Go to the Strategy tab. In the Machining tab, select Outer Part for the machining mode. Click Tool Path Replay. The new tool path is displayed. Click OK to close the operation dialog box and close to close the manufacturing view. Now we're going to generate an NC data file. Generating an NC output file. This task explains how to interactively generate NC code from the program you have just created. Save your process with file save as in the directory of your choice. You can give your process a name. Click Save. Select Generate NC Code Interactively from NC Output Management Toolbar. In the dialog box that is displayed, call your file Surface Machining. Browse to the directory where you want to save it if you like. Click Execute to create the apt file. The apt file can be read with any kind of text editor. You can create separate files for each operation by selecting Generate NC Code in Batch Mode and activating By Machining Operation choice. Generating NC shop floor documentation. This task explains how to interactively generate shop floor NC documentation in HTML format from the program you have just created. Select Generate Documentation. The Process Documentation dialog box is displayed. If documentation script is not set by default, you can use the machining document script you downloaded with sample parts. Leave process as the process name. Choose the directory where you want to save your new file. Give a main file name. Click OK. Your NC document has been created. You can inspect the created document using your web browser. After you finished, click OK and then close to close the dialog box. This concludes the operation-oriented surface machining tutorial. Second part will cover area-oriented surface machining. You can also check our channel to find out more about this workbench or other Catia workbenches. Thanks for listening.